Dark Matter News, I'm Leo Ashcraft. Has Atlantis been discovered in the Bermuda Triangle? Scientists working off the coast of Cuba have verified via sonar that there are ancient ruins at the bottom of the ocean, about a mile in depth. Four large pyramids and other city-like structures have been detected, which may have a connection with the legend of Atlantis, commonly known as the Cuban subsea complex. This discovery may lend support to the theory and speculations that Atlantis suffered from rising waters and eventually had its demise when the land sank into the Atlantic Ocean. A couple working with the Cuban government first reported on the discovery in 2001 and has since returned to the site for further investigation. Some symbols found on the structures were also found elsewhere in Cuba. It was estimated that it would have taken around 50,000 years for the structures to have sunk to its current depth. Large stone blocks and formations are clearly visible from the data, and a marine geologist stated that there are no known cultures at that time which had architectural capability to create such complicated formations. Well, by now you've heard the commercials for Alongside Night, but I wanted to tell you that I have personally watched this movie, and I absolutely love it. I don't normally personally endorse a product, but Alongside Night hits home with me on so many things that concern and affect me personally. It exposes the truths, the lies, and problems in our government. But it goes further. It offers solutions and hope, something we can all use right about now. Watch Alongside Night for entertainment, watch it for education, and most importantly, watch it for the future of America.
The 3-disc Blu-ray DVD combo pack of Alongside Night is on sale for $16.95, including shipping and handling. You can buy it online right now at Area51Movies.com. Or after 9:30 a.m. Eastern, phone 800-527-2375. Again, buy online now at Area51Movies.com. Or after 9:30 a.m. Eastern at 800-527-2375.
So what will happen if SETI actually makes contact? Will we even understand the language that is sent back in the message? The branch of SETI called Communication with Extraterrestrial Intelligence focuses on deciphering messages from space, whether it be a direct unencoded contact attempt or if the message is encrypted and needs to be decoded. After confirming a signal, the task of extracting information from it could prove to be an extensive process, depending on the nature of the received message. Many SETI researchers expect the signal to be a direct and deliberate contact, taking the form of an ambiguous nature. Andrew Seaman, a PhD candidate in astronomy at SETI Berkeley, says, due to the random motions of the particles that are ultimately at the source of natural electromagnetic emission, these emissions tend to get spread out in frequency or in time. Technology, on the other hand, is capable of producing very fine time and frequency structure. We can use this fine structure to distinguish between natural and unnatural sources. It is thought by scientists and mathematicians that forming a signal which denotes intelligence shouldn't be too difficult to create for our potential cosmic neighbors, and they expect the message to be in the form of a mathematical code and don't expect a signal that simply translates to, "Lucy, I'm home." The Atlantic Paranormal Society, otherwise known as TAPS, recently investigated the Wild Turkey Distillery in Anderson County, Kentucky. Some employees claim that the founding family member's ghost may be lurking about the plant. A human-like figure was discovered in a recent photo and has sparked curiosity. Wild Turkey employee Courtney Clare told investigators, "You would hear weird things get shifted. Sometimes we would hear laughter. The building was always kind of creepy anyways." Other employees claim that the noises may be caused by the ghost of two men who died at the distillery some years ago. The group plans to make a few stops in Kentucky for the 10th season of Ghost Hunters. The episode titled Barrel of Booze aired this week on the Sci-Fi Channel. NASA has confirmed that the Earth will experience 15 days of total darkness between November 15th and November 29th, 2015. The event, according to NASA, hasn't occurred in over 1 million years. So says the website Newswatch 33. While the article seems legit, and the NASA official cited in the article, Charles Borden, does work for NASA, according to Snopes, the website Newswatch 33 is not a legitimate news outlet. Snopes says that Newswatch 33 hoaxed social media users a number of times since its inception, falsely claiming supporters raised $4 million for the defense of Charleston shooting suspect Dylan Roof, that a girl was electrocuted by her iPhone earbuds, that Jay-Z and Beyonce purchased the rights to the Confederate flag, and that the government had impregnated inexpensive cigars with listening devices. The moral of the story: be careful what you read while surfing the internet.